Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome to Learning English TV. My name is Steve Ford, and today I will be teaching you things about family. So the first thing I want to tell you is that anything can grow in size. Plants, animals, people. When people reach adolescence, they grow quickly. And after some people get married, they start to grow sideways. Maybe you can remember when you were a teenager, or maybe you are a teenager, and your aunt or grandmother says something to you like, "Oh my goodness, you've grown 5 inches taller. You look just like your dad." But if you grow up, it's a little different. This describes your process of maturing from a child to a teenager and then to an adult, we hope. When we think of someone acting as a child, we say, "Grow up, act your age, not your shoe size." Okay, bring up versus educate. From the time you're a baby to the time that you're an adult, your mom and or your dad bring you up. Now, this means they feed you and hopefully love you and give you a place to live, etc. But in English, we say that teachers and professors hopefully educate you. Now, parents versus relatives. Some people are brought up by their parents, their mother and father, but sometimes that's not possible. And maybe your grandmother or your grandfather, aunt or uncle brought you up. I have one friend who was brought up by his grandparents on their farm, and he has great memories from that time. He absolutely loved his grandmother and her home cooking. Do you look like your dad? Do you have his nose? Maybe you have your mother's eyes. Look like means you have a similar physical appearance. Then we have personality, the way you are, the way you act. So if your dad is outgoing, extroverted, and gets along with everybody, has a friendly relationship with everyone, and so do you, we can say you take after your dad. Do you see the difference here between look like, appearance, and take after personality? Now, we all know that some traits, characteristics, run in the family. That means it's a common thing for people in your family. Are you and everyone in your family tall? Are you short? If they are, then being short or tall runs in your family. Well, everyone, I hope you enjoyed my lesson about families, and I will post a link for a quiz to help you remember the vocabulary, phrasal verbs, and all the other things that I've taught you today. See you in our next lesson. What do you call your mother's sister? Aunt. What do you call your brother's son? Nephew. What do you call your sister's daughter? Niece. What do you call your father's brother? Uncle. And what do you call your grandfather's father? Great-grandfather. What do you call your uncle's daughter? Think hard. Cousin, you did it. Did you go to the bar last night? Would you like to dance? It's good you're on our side. So, all of these examples use the J sound. Did you? Could you? Would you? You can make a game out of it by saying it with me. Here to boost your confidence. Yes, Steve is here with pronunciation and listening. So let's take a look at our first question from Gurari from Algeria.